Hi guys, I'm Regita Briliana, student of Business and Management School in Bandung Institute of Technology, and today, as my final exam assignment, I would like to deliver my research in a local brand, and this is my first video doing brand auditing for Pukka. Pukka is a local fashion brand from Indonesia that has been established in 2017. Pukka sells a kimono outer with a touch of message in every design that has designed authentically. Since Pukka is considered as a new fashion brand, that's still a lot of things that we should do as a brand auditor. Brand awareness is still an issue in this brand. So, what are we waiting for? Let's start right now! Pukka has many consignment stores and distribution channels. 3 offline consignment store, 2 online consignment store, 1 e-commerce, and 1 order via WhatsApp. Because Pukka were too focused on using consignment store at the first place, brand value will not well delivered. Why? Since Pukka is still considered as a new local brand that still have a low audience, by only focus in cooperation and widening the channel, it will lack in brand value delivery. So, what Pukka should do is widening the audience first, and then maintaining the audience and engagement. And how to maintain the audience and raise engagement? Since Instagram is their first brand touchpoint, their Instagram engagement rate was 0.18%, which considered as low engagement. Their audience were only the same audience over and over again, without any evolution. They need exposure through influencers, and they lack in marketing strategy. The solution that I propose is endorse with the influencers that has the right target audience. Influencers that concerned with fashion, or influencers that has represent a local product. You can choose Putri Marino or Tara Basro. Putri Marino that shares about Indonesia a lot in her Instagram account to gain the audience. After get a huge audience, they have to actively post interactive content that could make the audience engage with the brand. Also, Pukka could use social issues such as All Color is Beauty campaign or any women empowerment campaign, since nowadays, Gen Y and Gen Z were heavily influenced in social issue that emphasized in simplicity, women beauty standards, and used Tara Basro as the campaign ambassadors. Since she is an Indonesian iconic influencer that has a lot of social issue in their Instagram. The last problem is, there is no post-purchase activities to maintain brand relationship with the customers. This could miss the opportunity to gain brand loyalty from the customers. After having a huge audience, Pukka could try to giving the best post-purchase experience. Pukka could give a huge discount or loyalty card for their customers. Giving them discounts for the repurchase will trigger them to buy more and more product in the future. Because customer experience will lead into loyalty, and gaining customers' loyalty were much more cost-saving rather than gaining new customers. Since maintaining the customer's loyalty doesn't need much more marketing effort than rather than gaining a new customers. And that's the end of my 1 semester in brand auditing.